I'm making you a dish that has been called food for the gods. The dish I'm making today was inspired by the film Like Water for Chocolate. If you haven't seen it, it's a tragic love story, and food plays an important role in the film. These heads you see here were bathed in an amazing sauce. One of the key ingredients was red roses. This is dedicated to all my viewers with love for Valentine's Day. I invited Lucia back, and for both of us, this was the first time we attempted to make this dish. We could have perfected the dish and filmed once that was done. But instead, I prefer to show you the progression of experimenting with a new recipe and seeing the challenges we faced and how we overcame them. Begin by removing petals carefully from a dozen red, organic, and unsprayed roses. You'll end up with a big bowl of petals. The dish calls for quail, but it was hard to find at the market, so we used game hen instead.
She's ready for romance too.
So right now we're just grinding up the anise really, really well. We're using one of Claudia's favorite tools, the molcajete, which is kind of an old rustic way that people would grind up spices and get pastes and purees. It's kind of fun. Good stress release. You know, and it's funny, in grinding the anise, I can just, if only you could smell what we're doing. It's such an amazing, pungent, almost like a licorice scent, but it's really actually really nice, and I'm not really a licorice person either, but this is really, really cool. So we're gonna get it down to as far as I can take it, and then we're gonna go ahead and add in some other ingredients.
If you don't have a molcajete, get one soon. But for now, try using a food processor or a blender. That'll work as well.
So we're adding in some rose petals. I don't think we're gonna get a paste out of rose petal. I think what's gonna happen here is we're just gonna get the essence and the oil of it. I think it's gonna be amazing, and I think it's very romantic.
It's very romantic.
Yeah.
It's very romantic. It's sweet. It's the scent of floral,
yeah.
Sweet, and then nutty at the same time.
A little bit.
Yeah. A little tiny hint of nut. Yeah.
Yeah, but it's almost like a cinnamon, kind of. Did you get cinnamon out of it? Even though there's no cinnamon in it.
Yeah, exactly.
So this is kind of cool. So we're just basically bruising the heck out of these things because that's all we're really going to be able to do. And then we'll just stuff them inside the birds to infuse the flavor. And I think this will be a really nice, gentle.
It's funny because now I understand why they felt the way they did during the book and in the movie.
Uh-huh.
Because of the scent of all of this is just
intoxicating. It is. It really is. It's amazing. If only you could smell what we're doing. This is really cool, and it's not. It's a pretty simple recipe, actually. Mm-hmm. It's just because of the time that it was written and the time that it's created. You have to remember it was turn of the century Mexico, so they didn't have ovens, so you're not gonna have oven temperatures and things. So you kind of have to fill in the blanks a little bit. But the ingredients themselves are just, it's amazing. Who would have thought?
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
call for pitaya or dragon fruit, but I didn't find that at the market, so my produce guide recommended guava, which should have a tartier finish, which I actually kind of prefer because I like tart with anything sweet.
I'm curious. It's beautiful.
It's really colorful.
Kind of smells like caramel.
Kind of.
Lucia and I were really concerned about overcooking the rose sauce, so we decided to pre-cook the hands until they started to brown. After the sauce was done, we rubbed the sauce all over the hens and stuffed some inside the cavity, and then immediately put them back in the oven. So since you know we experimented for the first time with this dish, and one thing I could have done differently, especially in this process, is I would have set aside some of that rose mixtures so that I could have pureed it until it became a really nice, fine sauce consistency, because I would have liked to pour that over the hens once after they were done cooking.
So I'm going to put my food for the gods in the oven.
So I encourage you to experiment with recipes you come across like Lucia and I did, especially for your loved ones. That's the only way you'll become a more romantic cook.
I want you guys to try it. Let me know how it goes. Let me know if you have some more tips for me for this dish. Maybe I can improve it, make it better. I want to hear from you guys because you're all very smart and you always have something to say. So.
And if you're looking for dating advice, the do's and don'ts of Valentine's Day, my friends the Wing Girls has a really great episode for you on the do's and don'ts of Valentine's Day, and I think we all could use some advice sometimes, don't you think? So my question for you, do you think certain dishes have an effect of lust and love?
Je vais quitter cette vie dans les prochaines heures. J'ai beau me dire qu'en somme ce n'est rien qu'un passage. J'ai beau me dire...